I'm Craig Rodriguez. I'm a member of the FreeBSD project. I work on the release engineering team. So Glenn Barber is the lead release engineer, but I help Glenn, along with Shin, who's also on the release engineering team, put out the FreeBSD releases. And I also work at IX Systems in San Jose on FreeNAS. And so today my presentation, I'm not going to talk about FreeNAS, but this is a FreeBSD specific presentation, specifically on work done in the FreeBSD cluster. And so I'm going to talk about Jenkins and continuous integration for FreeBSD. So just to give you an idea of what I'm, okay, so the first question is, yes, these slides are going to be online later. And so on the meetup site, there will be a note telling you where to get the slides. So that's the answer to your first question. So what I'm going to talk about is, for those of you who may not know what Jenkins and continuous integration is, I'll give a brief introduction to that. Not too much. There's a lot of other places where you can learn about that, but just to give you an idea. And also, I will describe specifically what work has been done to set up Jenkins up in the FreeBSD cluster. And so I'll talk about Jenkins first. So Jenkins is a tool. It's written in Java. It is used for continuous integration. And it was written by Kosuke Kawaguchi at Sun, before Sun was acquired by Oracle. And it was originally called Hudson. And then Oracle acquired Sun, and then there was a lot of drama, and the project forked, and a lot of whatever. And so the project forked and became Jenkins. And the original Hudson project, which is at Oracle, is more or less dead, and Jenkins is the successor to Hudson. So Jenkins is an open source project. You can find out a lot more information at the main Jenkins site, jenkins-ci.org. Or Googling around. There are hundreds of plugins available, hundreds of users, many projects, many companies, very active developer community. And so there was a conference actually in Palo Alto in, I believe it was in October. And so I attended this conference, and so this gentleman here works for a company called CloudBees. So the original Jenkins author works at CloudBees. And so he dressed as a Jenkins, an English butler kind of guy. So I had to put that in my slide deck. What I found very interesting about the conference, there were 500 people at the conference and 500 people dialed in via webcast. So 1,000 people at the conference. And I couldn't even get parking to go to this conference. So it's a very active and lively community and user base. And so what is continuous integration all about? So there's probably lots of sophisticated explanations for this, but I'll give you my take on what this is about. And if any of you who are experienced software developers, there's no magic about this. You've been doing this for years. But basically, as a software developer, what you normally do is you develop code, you commit code to SCM, and then you normally have some kind of script or system that takes your commits and builds them and then makes sure that the build doesn't break. And then, you could have some automated testing and regression system, and then you deploy the code. So everywhere I've worked at has had these things, and probably everywhere you've worked at has had these things as well. And these things are normally have been different in each company. They've been hand-coded and specific, and you go to the next company and they have a very similar thing, but it's written in its own way. So these days, with things like Jenkins and there are other things, people are like, we have an open source framework, we're solving the same problem, let's just, use a common code base to do all this stuff. So I took this slide from a company called LiveRebel. And all the things that I described, this is the workflow that they're putting together with Jenkins. And so source control, trigger a build, do a build. do some testing, staging, whatever. And it's nothing very complicated about any of that. So Jenkins in the FreeBSD cluster. So why do this? So in the FreeBSD cluster, it's like a company. So in FreeBSD, we have some things that kind of do this. We have a system called FreeBSD Tinderbox, which pulls different branches and builds things and reports build breaks. And that's been around for about 15 years or so. But what I saw going to the Jenkins conference and also in my own work at IX Systems, what I saw is that there's a very lively community around this, and I think it would be good for the FreeBSD project to embrace these more modern toolkits for doing FreeBSD and making FreeBSD better. And when we use these things and show that it works on FreeBSD, then we can show this to companies that are used to using tools like Jenkins. Like, hey, you can use Jenkins. I know it works on Linux, but you know what? It works on FreeBSD, so you can develop your product on FreeBSD, and all your continuous integration, QA engineers who are used to these tools, you can use them here too. So there's a lot to be said for working with these existing ecosystems. So, setting it up. So, the first thing, and this is pretty mundane stuff, and I was just talking to Neil about some of the ways how you want to set something up in a company or whatever, it's no different than FreeBSD. So, the first thing that I'll explain is, when you access www.freebsd.org, svnfreebsd.org, forums.freebsd.org, or many different machines in the FreeBSD cluster, there's a team of people that administer this cluster. They are the FreeBSD cluster administration team. And I was hoping some of them could be here today, but a couple of them are out at AsiaBSDCon. But to briefly describe the FreeBSD cluster, there are three main places where machines that are in the FreeBSD cluster are located. One is at Yahoo in Sunnyvale. The other is at ISC in Redwood City. And there are a lot of machines at ISP in the New York City area called NYI. But the main cluster admin people are at Yahoo. Peter Wen and Sean Bruno, they are probably the main people who really keep things going and humming in the FreeBSD project. So the first thing that I had to do is, I have run Jenkins in 4 on FreeBSD, but I said it's not enough for me to do it on my own machine. I want to do it in the FreeBSD cluster itself. So I had to ask cluster admin for a machine, and they have a ticketing system, and so I filed a ticket and then sent them an email. I said, look, this is what I want to do and why. And this is who's going to access the machine and the purpose and all that. So exactly the same if you were in a company and you wanted to do something, I had to do. And so they gave me a machine, and that's not the actual host name. So I put a dummy one in there just for illustration purposes. But they gave me a machine with 16 gigs of RAM and about 2 terabytes disks. I forget how many disks are there. 16-core machine running FreeBSD 11. So then what I did is I wanted to have multiple Jenkins instances running different versions of FreeBSD. And so I set up one VM running FreeBSD 9 and one running FreeBSD 10. And I also was very interested in kind of pushing the envelope and using the new FreeBSD hypervisor, which is in FreeBSD 10 and up. And one of the co-authors of that is here today, Neil Natu. And so basically I created two VMs and I installed FreeBSD in them and I ran them on Bhyve on this one machine. Because the same thing that I found in companies is the same thing in FreeBSD project. It's easier to ask for one thing than to ask for two. So I asked for one thing, which is a machine, and then I turned it into two things. So the next thing that I did was I created some RCD scripts which start VMs on loop. And then I used something called the NMDM driver, which is a null modem driver. And if I have time at the end of the presentation, I can start a VM on this laptop and kind of show you how I access the console of the VM. And so so if you're familiar with the modems, like from the olden days,
yeah.
The NMDM is a null modem device.
Cool.
So it creates two endpoints in the dev directory. So there will be NMDM0A and NMDM0B. So you write to NMDM0A, and then you connect a client to NMDM0B. And so I use the CU client, which is like old school BSD way of connecting to a serial port. I mean, that's older than even me. I used to use Minicom a lot under Linux in the 90s, and even Telex under DOS, but, you know, I use CU. And so then I installed Jenkins, and it's very easy to install in FreeBSD. It's in ports. I did package install devel Jenkins. That pulls in the OpenJDK. And did a little fiddling in rc.conf. And did service Jenkins start. And done. It's running under FreeBSD. Then the next thing that I did was, so when I started Jenkins, I started Jenkins on the Jenkins 9 FreeBSD.org host. But I wanted, and then when it starts, the default port is 8180, and the root is /Jenkins. And so I wanted end users not to have to remember this URL. And so I set up Nginx reverse proxy. So if you can actually, I don't have my laptop connected to the internet because I didn't want to risk it with this projector and all this stuff. But if any of you are on the internet, if you go to jenkins.freebsd.org, you can poke around and see that system that's running there right now. And so I used Nginx, I configured used an SSL certificate. And so then what I have looks like this. I don't know how clear that is on the projector, but this entire white box is a FreeBSD 11. So this is the 16 gig machine. And then this is one VM. And this is running FreeBSD 9. And this is the other VM running FreeBSD 10. So on FreeBSD 9, which is one of these boxes, when you do a web request to to jenkins.freebsd.org, you go through this Nginx proxy, and then the proxy then goes and accesses jenkins9.freebsd.org, colon 8180, /Jenkins, and then gets you through there. And so that's how I set that up. The next thing that I had to do was, so by default, when you set up Jenkins, there's no authentication. And so as soon as it's up on the web, you can go and log in, and anyone can do anything, and anyone can administer it. But if I'm having something on the open internet, I cannot do that. But I need to have a way where people can see the web interface, but I have to have a certain limited set of users who have administrative privileges and can do stuff. So in the FreeBSD cluster, the cluster administration team, they have an LDAP server internally in the FreeBSD cluster. And so this is used for different applications. What I did in Jenkins is I configured LDAP. And so now the Jenkins authenticates against the FreeBSD LDAP servers. So this kind of looks like this. I don't know how clear this is, but so again, this is the Nginx proxy, this is the VM, and then this is running, Java VM is running Jenkins. So when you try to log in, this will go and authenticate with the LDAP server at Yahoo. So if you're a FreeBSD committer, depending on how long you became a committer, you may have forgotten, but there's actually a step when you become a new committer. One of the things you have to do is you can log in and create a Kerberos login. So that Kerberos login is used with the LDAP servers. So if you're a FreeBSD committer, you can actually SSH to, I think it's kadmin.freebsd.org. And Peter Wen has a service where as soon as you SSH in, it will generate a Kerberos password and spit it out on the console, and it'll tell you, don't show anyone this, don't forget this, whatever. And so you can do that. And so in Jenkins, I've configured 5 users to authenticate against that LDAP server. And so the 5 users are different people who are helping me with this. And so once I got that going, then I set up what are called freeform builds. So everything in Jenkins is administered through a web user interface. And at the end of the presentation, I have a sample Jenkins instance running on my laptop. I can quickly drive through the UI for that to give you an idea of what it can do. On Unix, in a freeform build, you enter commands in a web form, in a text entry field. And what happens is, when Jenkins runs your job, it will generate a bourne shell script in /temp, and it will execute it with -binsh -x -e. So minus x shows every command in the shell script as it's being executed, and minus e will terminate on error. So it will do that if the stuff you enter in the freeform text lacks a pound exclamation point, the shebang. If you have a shebang, it will honor the shebang. It won't do the minus x e trick. So you can actually have like Python or whatever, but on Unix, people generally just put shell. On Windows, people put command PowerShell kind of things. And so when you're done, you have this. This is a screenshot of jenkins.freebsd.org. If any of you are on the internet, you can poke there and see that running right now. And so you'll see that we have multiple builds. We're building head and modules, and Li Guan Su set up the Clang scan build, and we've been building stable 10, stable 8, stable 9. And so we have this host here. Is the pre-master, which is FreeBSD 9. And this is a FreeBSD 10 host, so we're trying to distribute the builds across multiple hosts. And so you can click on these things and look at like the build history, errors, there's a RSS feed, or if you want to see what build things, they distribute the builds and failures and stuff like that. And this is like all out of the box. You don't have to do a lot of configuration. Can do more configuration if you want, but what is there out of the box is very, very powerful. And so what do we have so far? So I mentioned in the CI workflow, we have commits, and then we go to the SCM and we build. But the things that we don't have here are test and deploy. So we just got started with this. I got this going on like mid-February. And so we need to kind of improve on the last part. So if you go to this page here, wiki.freebsd.org/Jenkins, that is the web page that lists the project status. This is what we're working on, this is who's working on it, and kind of what we're doing, and all that kind of stuff. And so we kind of like to keep an open record of what we're doing. So the last two parts, actually, if any of you are going to BSDCAN in May, I'm going to probably give the same presentation at BSDCAN, but before BSDCAN, I'm actually going to host a working group on continuous integration. I think it's on May 15th, so if any of you are in Ottawa, it would be good to get together and talk about this and see what we can add or improve. I've contacted Julio Marino, who he is a, I think he lives in New York, and he works at Google, but he does a lot of work on NetBSD and FreeBSD. He's written a testing framework called QA. It is spelled K-Y-U-A, but it is pronounced QA. But it's a framework where you can run different types of tests, and it has a common reporting output. And so I've sort of started the thread with him and saying, hey, we can integrate your thing with this. Jenkins has some books where if you have a testing framework that writes out its output in a certain XML format, the test results will actually show up in the web UI. And so I sort of said to Julio, you already have a testing framework. It is used actively in FreeBSD. There are companies like Isilon and Spectralogic and others who are big FreeBSD users who are kind of looking at that. So if you already have something, it already does this, the test part, then let's see if we can just make the output of that compatible with this and integrate it and see what we can do. And then the deployment part, we need to figure out what we're going to do there. So that will involve kind of working with release engineering and seeing how we can fit into what they're doing. And so what's next? So I mentioned integrating with QA, setting up more builds, and doing more testing and more smoke testing of builds. There's a lot of things we can do. We can like integrate with Coverity. There's a Coverity instance in the FreeBSD cluster that has gotten various amounts of love over the years, and I think now it's in an unloved era. So if we could bring that back and integrate this, I think it would be really good. And so what I would like to see is I would like to see this stuff being used. I would like to see the FreeBSD project make more use of the best practices in industry, and also be a shining example of this is how you do things. Because there are many companies that they really don't know how to do this stuff, and they want to do it, so they look around often to open source projects and use their model for setting up these systems, even setting up SCMs, setting up daily builds. So if we can do things well in FreeBSD, then other people can benefit from this. And Jenkins is already used heavily in other projects. Like there's a Jenkins project, and I think it's in Ubuntu. They have like over 200 builds in Jenkins, so it's already used. And so where do you find out more? So this is the project page in FreeBSD, what we're doing. If you have any questions, or if you think that you can say, hey, I have really good scripts for booting images and VMs, and I think integrate with what you're doing, it would be really good. There's a FreeBSD testing mailing list, so join in on that. Join in, help out, and see what you can help out with. And so that's pretty much my presentation. So the team that is doing this, so this is our mailing alias where we're setting up and administering this stuff. So there's me, Craig Rodriguez. So these are all at freebsd.org mail addresses. So that's me. I work at IX and FreeBSD Release Engineering. So I'm here in the Bay Area. Li Wen is in Taiwan. He works at Yahoo in Taiwan. And he actually works heavily with Yahoo. Is a heavy, heavy user of Jenkins. They have thousands of Jenkins builds going on. So he is actually the port maintainer of Devel Jenkins. Steve Kreutzer, he's our one of our DevOps Ninja guys. He works at Hudson River Trading in New York City. Very familiar with Jenkins. He's helping out. Steve Wills, I think he's on the US East Coast. He maintains, there's another port called Devel Jenkins LTS. So LTS you can consider like, it's called long-term support. So it's like kind of a Jenkins port that it doesn't change so much. Jenkins is it goes through a lot of churn because it's a very active developer community. And so that goes through a lot of revs. So the LTS port doesn't change so much. And then the other guy helping us out is Tyler Croy. And so Tyler is actually, I believe he's in, I have not met him yet, but he is in San Francisco. And what I found very interesting about Tyler is he knows Coastal K very well, and he actually works on Jenkins itself. And when he found out when I was doing email, he said, hey, I work on Jenkins. What can I do to help this work better on FreeBSD? And I'm like, you know what? I have some things for you to do. So he's helping us out. Then the other people that helped us out, and I really could not have got this done without them, is the cluster administration team. So I'm just mentioning three, Sean Bruno and Peter Wem, they're at Yahoo, and Glenn Barber, he's in Philadelphia. So Glenn is actually one of the few people who are full-time salaried employees of the FreeBSD Foundation. So Glenn works on release engineering and cluster administration. But these three helped me in terms of setting up the machine, and you know, when I first did some things, I misconfigured things and rebooted things and didn't have the network configured, and you know, they were very kind about you know, cleaning up when I messed things up. So basically that's my presentation. You know, some glue that has to be written to, like glue Bhyve into things like Vagrant.
Is there a repository where the scripts are? So
not yet, but I'm gonna put it online in like the next week, and I'll update the wiki.freebsd.org/Jenkins. So I mean, there's no magic to the scripts that I did. I mean, there's other people like who's that guy, Michael Dexter, who's just a script guy. I start like a caveman. I have a rock, and then I pick it up, then I bang my head with it, and then I say, oh, I shouldn't do that. And I keep doing that until something works, and then I have a script. So I'm not too sophisticated, but hey, what I have works. So definitely I will share what I have and post it on the wiki page.
Can I ask one more?
Yeah.
How much of this is, so if we follow the wiki page, are there instructions for setting this up for our own internal use?
I'm adding that now. So I mean, this is all like fast moving, and but I'm basically what I'm trying to do is like I have these other people helping me, and they're like all over the place. And what I'm telling them is like I don't want to be like the sole arbiter of this stuff. So all the stuff that I'm doing is all in the public domain. And I want other people to be able to help me with this stuff, but also, like I said, I want people to look at this and say, hey, this is a good way to do things in my own company. Let's, you know, why should I figure this stuff out myself? That's why I started using Jenkins in the first place. So I was working on IX, and I needed to set up something to do daily builds, and I'm like, I've written scripts like that, like 10, 15 years ago, and I'm like, hell with that, I'm lazy, man. See what other people have done. Take that stuff and use it. Go home. So, you know, it's going to be like this. And honestly, FreeBSD, we're behind the curve on this stuff. If you look at what people are doing in the Linux world, they were doing this stuff like 5, 6, 7 years ago. And the workflows they have are so sophisticated. You know, many of you are probably familiar with them if you work in different companies, or especially startups. And they just take it for granted that you can build these systems and boot hundreds of things in VMs. And, so honestly, FreeBSD is behind the curve on that. But I think with things like Bhyve, we can prove that we can run Jenkins and Java. I think we can catch up and do some cool things.
So maybe I zoned out, but are you building just native, or are you building universe? How long does it take, and what triggers the build, or do you just do it?
So I wanted to show this in the UI, but unfortunately that didn't work. So there's different ways to trigger builds. One is to pull the SCM. So in the UI, you say, this is the URL to check out the source tree, and that URL could be Subversion or Git or whatever. And so one way is to say, pull this SCM every hour, and then if it's new, then update it and build. So that's what I have right now. For stuff that I've done at IX, what I have done is, so at IX internally on FreeNAS, we use Git. And what I've done is in Git, I have added commit triggers. So when you do a commit, then in the commit trigger, it invokes a program called curl. And curl can go and do an HTTP request. So curl does an HTTP request on the Jenkins server with a particular string which indicates certain information about which build of the many builds. And so there's two ways. You can have Jenkins pull the SCM, or you can have the SCM poke Jenkins. And both are possible. For what I've done in the FreeBSD cluster, it's pulling, but I've done the other way in things that are not.
It seems like what you really want is to know, you know, exactly when something broke. So you probably don't have enough horsepower to do that.
So I mean, it depends. So I mean, what you can do is you can scale this out and have 100, 200 builds. You can have them on different branches, different architectures, different machines. And so if you have a commit, it'll trigger the build or wherever. And basically what you want is, when a developer commits, you want the developer to be notified as quickly as possible. Because the developer will commit and they'll go home. And so if they find out 3 hours later they broke the build, it's too late. So you want to bring that time down as much as possible.
Can you make it so that you can submit to Jenkins as opposed to directly to the tree?
There are ways to do that. There are plugins to do that. I have not set any of that stuff up. So at the Jenkins conference in Palo Alto, there was I forget the name of the plugin, but there was a plugin that someone wrote that did pretty much that, but it was heavily Git-based. So there was a way where your submit was actually a Git push, but then it did the push and then did the build, and then if you could have it just go by build, or you could have it do build and test, and then if it passed all that, then it would push to the real Jenkins repository. And offhand, I don't remember the name of that plugin, but that's pretty close to what you were.
Garrett does the same thing.
Garrett?
It uses like Git gymnastics, so if you ever accomplish that.
Yeah. But I mean, that's a very, very useful workflow. I mean, part of things, I just started learning about this stuff around October, so I'm kind of new to this stuff. But there are people around that know this a lot better than me. But I mean, one advantage is that there's so many plugins for this thing. I mean, there's like hundreds. There's like around 700 or more.
Levels and more.
Huh?
Levels and more.
It's all right. There's a lot of things in FreeBSD that are
so, it's pretty bad, I would say.
But I mean, 200 of those work. That's probably about 190 more than I'll ever use anymore. So.
Are you using snapshots for your VMs at all? Do you restore them to like a known state before you give out the build?
No, I'm not doing anything like that yet. But I mean, if you have ideas like that, post them on FreeBSD testing.
Any other questions? Or?